Today in this video, we will learn about partition coefficient, which is also called as distribution law or distribution coefficient. So we will learn about the concept of partition coefficient in this video, and we will also solve some exam style questions related to this topic. Let's start with the definition of partition coefficient. Partition coefficient is the ratio of the concentration of a solute which is dissolved in two different immiscible solvents when an equilibrium is established between these two solvents. Now let's understand what do we mean by this definition. Suppose in a separating funnel we have taken water as an aqueous solvent, in which suppose if we have some solute dissolved into it, say solute X, and then we can add an organic solvent on the top of this and then shake it. After shaking, we can see that the two different layers of the solvents have separated out in the separating funnel. But then what is going to happen is that the solute molecule is going to get distributed between the two solvents. That is, it keeps on moving between the two solvents, that is, the molecules from the aqueous solvent will keep on moving to the organic solvent and from organic solvent to the aqueous solvent. Now, according to the solubility of this solute between the solvents, some of the molecules will dissolve in the organic solvent and remaining will stay back in the water. But then the movement of these molecules between the solvents keeps on going on till the equilibrium has reached. Now, what do we mean by equilibrium? It says that if some molecules from organic solvent has moved to the aqueous solvent, then the same number of molecules will move from aqueous solvent to the organic solvent. So here we say an equilibrium has reached. So you can say that the movement of molecules between the solvent remains same, which we call it as equilibrium. So, at equilibrium, suppose the concentration of solute X in aqueous solvent is something and concentration of the same solute in organic solvent is again something, then we can express the equilibrium expression as shown here. Now suppose if we take an example of say ammonia solute. So ammonia is soluble in water to some extent and ammonia is also soluble in organic solvent to some extent, but the solubility of ammonia in both the solvents is different. Say suppose there are some molecules of ammonia in organic solvent and water as a solvent, that is aqueous solvent, then the ammonia molecules in organic solvent will have some concentration and the molecules of ammonia in aqueous solvent again will have some concentration. The concentration of these ammonia molecules in organic solvent and in aqueous solvent is taken into consideration, and the ratio of these two concentration equals to the partition coefficient. So this is what, when we say that the ratio of the concentration of a solute in two different immiscible solvents mean here. So partition coefficient is the ratio of any one solute in organic solvent and aqueous solvent. Now if here we have taken an example of ammonia, then KPC for ammonia in organic solvent, suppose if we have taken organic solvent as propanol, then the ratio of this ammonia in propanol and aqueous, that is KPC of ammonia in propanol and aqueous solution, will remain constant. So the value of KPC will remain same for ammonia in propanol and aqueous, that is water as a solvent. So, you can call KPC, that is partition coefficient, as equilibrium constant also, which here we have called partition coefficient, or we can also call it as distribution constant. But we need to understand some concepts about partition coefficient, that This value is constant, but it will vary in some conditions. Say, for example, if we are changing the solvent or solute, then the value of KPC, that is partition coefficient, is going to change. Another condition is that if the changing the volume of a solvent, if we are suppose changing the volume of aqueous or organic solvent, then that will not change the value of partition coefficient. So partition coefficient is independent of the volume of the solvents. It remains constant at a particular temperature. So we need to consider temperature also when we are talking about partition coefficient, because again, the value of partition coefficient is going to change, vary with the temperature. But with partition coefficient, there are two limitations also. Now let's see what are these two limitations. The solutions which we are considering should be reasonably dilute. Say suppose if we are taking a concentrated solution of ammonia in either aqueous or any organic solvent, then we may not see the KPC value constant. So we need to take the solution reasonably dilute. The second part is that solute must not react with any of the solvent, or it should not ionize into the solvent. That is, suppose if we have taken some solute in aqueous, that is water, and it reacts with the water, then we can't consider the concentration of that solute in aqueous. So that's the reason that again the KPC value will get affected. So the most important part is that the solvent should remain dilute, that is the solution made should be dilute, and the solute should not react with any of the solvent taken into consideration. Now let's solve some examples of questions to understand this concept well. Here is our first example. It says a solution of P. Now P is a solute here for us, and P in water is taken, that is the solution of P in aqueous is taken, and it is shaken with a benzene as an organic solvent. The concentration of P in water was found to be 0.001 moles per dm³, and its concentration in benzene was found to be 0.02 moles per dm³. Now calculate the partition coefficient of solute P between benzene and water. So let's start by writing the expression of KPC, that is, we have to write the expression as the concentration of P in organic solvent, that is benzene, is to the concentration of P in aqueous solvent, that is water. Now the concentration of P in benzene is 0.02 moles per dm³ divided by its concentration is in water, that is 0.001. Now taking the ratio of these two values, we get 20 as the answer. So the partition coefficient of solute P in benzene and water is 20. Now we need to remember that this partition coefficient, this constant, is the ratio of two such values which have same unit, that is the concentration is moles per dm³. It's also divided by the same concentration moles per dm³. So such a concentration, that is such a constant KPC, doesn't have any unit. So we don't need to mention any unit here besides 20. Now let's consider another example. It says 2 gram of substance X, again X is a solvent, which is shaken with a mixture of 100 centimeter cube of hexane as an organic solvent and 50 centimeter cube of water. At equilibrium, the water layer was found to contain 0.40 gram of X. Calculate the partition coefficient of X between hexane and water. So writing the KPC expression, we get concentration of X in hexane, that is organic solvent, and concentration of X in aqueous, that is water. But now the most important part is that we don't have a concentration directly given into the question, but we are given the mass and volume. Now to get the concentration, we actually need moles and volume. But to calculate the moles, we should have mass and its relative mass. But here we don't need to consider the relative mass, as the relative mass of x in the numerator and in denominator will remain same and it will get cancelled. So we can use directly the mass given to us to calculate the concentration. So let's start by calculating the concentration of x in water. Now the mass of x in water is 0.40 gram and the volume of water taken is 50 centimeter cube. So dividing these two values, we get 0.008. If we want to write the unit, it is grams per centimeter cube. Now this is the concentration of x in water. Now let's read the question again. It says that total of 2 gram of substance is taken, out of which water had 0.4 gram. So remaining must have remained in the hexane. So considering the concentration of X in organic solvent, we need to write as 2 minus 0.4 gram, which is remaining in the organic solvent, that is hexane, divided by its volume, that is 100 centimeter cube, which gives us a value of 0.016 grams per centimeter cube. Now substituting these two values, that is the concentration of organic solvent, which is 0.016, divided by the concentration of X in aqueous solution, that is 0.008, we get the value 2, which again has no unit. So our KPSA value in this case is 2. Now here again we need to understand one more point, that suppose our value of KPC is greater than 1. That shows that the solubility of the solute X, say, which is considered here X, is greater in organic solvent compared to the aqueous solvent. And if the value of KPC is less than 1, then its solubility in the aqueous solvent will be greater than the organic solvent. Let's solve one more example. It says a 10 gram of a compound Y is dissolved in 100 centimeter cube of water and 20 centimeter cube of ether is shaken with the solution of Y. The value of partition coefficient here is 10. So how much of Y is removed from the water? Now let's understand what exactly is asked here. It says that total of 100 gram of solute Y is taken in water and we are shaking 20 centimeter cube of ether. So obviously some gram of solute Y is going to move out of water, that is going to get removed out of water, and that amount of water is going to get dissolved in ether. So our main question is that what mass of compound Y has dissolved in ether? So writing the expression of KPC, we get the concentration of Y in organic solvent is to the concentration of Y in aqueous solvent. Now we don't know that what amount of Y is dissolved in ether, so we are taking that as X amount. Now for concentration, we divide this amount by its volume. Volume means the volume of ether, so which is 20. Now we take the ratio of the concentration of Y in water. So now if X has moved in ether, then out of 10, what is left in the water is 10 minus X. And again, this is divided by the volume of water, which is 100 centimeter cube, so which we consider here as 100. So rewriting the expression, we will get as x into 100 divide by 20 into 10 minus x. Now, we know the value of KPC, which is 10. It's given in the question that the value of partition coefficient is 10. Now, solving for x, we get the value of x as x divided by 10 minus x, which will give 10 into 20 divided by 100. Now, solving for x again here will give us the value of x is equal to 6.67 gram, which can be solved in calculator. So, we can say that 6.67 gram of solute Y is removed from the water, or we can also say it is extracted from the water. Now, here we had taken 20 centimeter cube of ether altogether. But if we solve the same substance, that is, we repeat the same process, but not with 20 centimeter cube of ether, but by 10 centimeter cube of ether, repeating it twice. That is, we take the same amount of substance Y in same volume of water, but we take 10 centimeter cube of ether, we extract out some solute Y, and then again shake the new solute, that is the same substance, removing out the ether, we again take one more time 10 centimeter cube of ether and extract some more amount of Y. So let's consider another such example where the same substance Y is removed, but twice by taking 10 centimeter cube of ether each time. But we need to remember that in the same case, we had taken 10 gram of Y at the starting in 100 centimeter cube of water. And then we are shaking this solution with 10 centimeter cube of ether once and again with one more 10 centimeter cube of fresh ether. So in each time, we will be able to extract out some amount of Y. So in all, how much of Y is removed in total from the water? Now let's see that altogether 20 centimeter cube of ether removes out Y more in amount, or doing it twice this way will remove out or extract out Y more in amount. So let's again start by writing the expression of KPC, that is the concentration of Y in organic solvent and concentration of Y in aqueous solvent. Now we know that some X amount has been removed from water. So X divided by its volume, that is 10 centimeter cube, and the remaining is in water, that is 10 minus x again divided by its volume, that is 100 centimeter cube of water. And we know that the value of KPC is 10. So let's find out the value of x here. X is equal to 10 minus x. So this will give us a value of x is equal to 5 grams. Now this shows that 5 gram of substance Y is removed out of water and only 5 is remaining in the water. So now if we consider the whole process again, then KPC is again the same expression, writing concentration of Y in organic solvent and concentration of Y in aqueous solvent. But now the difference is that in place of X, let's consider some other value like Z. Some Z is extracted of, say Z gram of Y is extracted in ether. That should be divided by its volume, that is 10. Now what is remaining in the water? Remaining in the water was 5 gram, out of which Z went to the organic solvent. So in water it is 5 minus Z divided by its volume, that is 100. And we know that the value of KPC is 10. So this will give us the value of Z as half of the total, that is, as we have got 5 out of 10, this time we will get 2.5 grams. So in all, in the two sequence, the total amount of Y which had been removed out of water is 5 plus 2.5 gram, that is 7.5 gram. Now we had seen in earlier case that just taking either 20 centimeter altogether extracted Y as 6.67 gram. Now the value of Y extracted in sequence turn wise gives us more value of Y compared to what was extracted by altogether. So extraction of a substance this way stepwise can help us in extracting more amount. So here we have learned three examples of partition coefficient, and also we had tried to understand the concept of partition coefficient, which is also called as distribution law or distribution coefficient.